From DocuSign, this is Developing with DocuSign. This video is the first of a multi-part instructional series on how to migrate your application from DocuSign Legacy Auth to OAuth. I'm Nima Pulat, a developer advocate with DocuSign. In this video, I will tackle Java applications. Please check out our videos in this series for other SDK languages. Before DocuSign began using OAuth 2.0 to issue access tokens, our legacy authentication required sending your account password in plain text as a header. As straightforward as that is, it goes without saying that sending sensitive data in an insecure manner should be avoided at all costs. If you already have integration that use the outdated means for API authentication, you should start migrating them to use OAuth 2.0 standard. In this video, I'll show you how easy it is to migrate your integration to OAuth 2.0 authentication using the JWT grant method from the Java SDK. If you're wondering whether your integration uses legacy authentication, search for the x-DocuSign authentication header in your code. If the header is present, you're using legacy authentication. If the header exists in your code and you're using Java, your integration will look something similar to the following. You're setting a default header with x-DocuSign authentication, and this header is a dictionary of values. Now, notice how your username and password are in plain text inside the header. Now, let's go ahead and try to migrate this code to the new and secure OAuth 2.0. But before we do that, we need to gather some information from your admin dashboard. First, let's go ahead and collect some information that we're going to need to perform OAuth. Navigate to your apps and keys page, and then find the integrator key that you'll be using in your integration. Then navigate down to RSA key pairs and generate a pair. You want to go ahead and save the public key and your private key in a safe location, as you will need them in order to perform OAuth. Next up, you want to navigate to the user page, and you want to find the user ID of the user that you'll be impersonating. So select the user and go ahead and open it. And make note of the API username. This is the user ID that you'll be using to impersonate when you use OAuth. All right, now let's see how we can get an access token using the new OAuth 2.0 authentication. First of all, let me call out that I'll be using the JWT grant flow here. With the JWT user authentication method, you'll be impersonating another user. The way you get an access token is by calling the request JWT user token method. This method takes in a couple of inputs. Let's go over them one by one. Client ID and user ID are the parameters that you obtain from the admin dashboard. Along with that, you also need to provide the scopes that you'll be needing access to. The scopes is an array of different permissions that you'll be using. In this case, we're only using the e-signature APIs, so the scopes of signature is enough. It is worth mentioning that the user has to consent to the request of the scopes. Next up, you have to provide a byte array that represents your private key. Again, remember that you obtain your private key from your admin dashboard. The reason why we have to provide a private key is because you have to sign the token payload before sending it along with the request. Last but not least, you have to provide the expiration time for the token. The JWT tokens are only valid for 1 hour, therefore we specify 3600, which represent the number of seconds the token is valid. Now, after this method is completed, you get an access token, and the very next step is to set the access token as a default header on your requests. Okay, so let me run this code, and let's see if we can get an access token. Okay, we just hit the hit point, so let me scroll over this. All right, now if you look at the OAuth token variable, we're going to see that we were given a valid access token. And in the next step, we're going to set this token as our default header. Okay, perfect. That complete as well. From this point on, you can call our eSignature APIs the way you used to do before. So the rest of your code will remain intact. In this scenario, I'm simply getting the number of envelopes that are listed in my account, but your code could be doing whatever it was doing before and no changes are needed at this point. Please keep in mind that the token is only valid for an hour and you need to get a new token when the old one expires. You can also use the same token to make as many API calls as you like while the token is valid. You do not need to get a new token for every API call. In a future video, I will show you how you can renew your token after the old one expires. And that's it for today. Thank you so much for joining us today. Please be sure to subscribe to our channel so you won't miss any future videos that I'll be making in this series. Thank you.